to begin scanning. And the piece that I'm going to scan today is a winglet body part from a Red Bull Formula One racing car.
Okay, terrific.
So I'm going to step around here. And the software that we're using is PC-DMIS Reshaper. It is a three-dimensional point cloud processing software that I can use to generate a high-quality mesh and to also to create surfaces and B-splines that I can export to a CAD model.
I like all the different colors.
Yeah.
What are they for?
what that does is it actually creates each scan pass as a separate color. That just makes my job easier when I'm editing the point cloud data later on. I can identify each scan pass by color and then do some of my editing at that time on the individual scan pass. I'm going to continue here to fill in the holes and gaps that might be there in the data.
So you just want to make sure that you completely cover the surface of the model.
That's correct. The system also has an auto zoom feature, so you can see that the data rotates automatically and follows the perspective of the laser line.
So you can always see on the screen what it is you're scanning.
Well, and more importantly, I can see where I need to fill in just by moving the laser line
right. To
that area of the part.
Okay.
So I'm going to tap a button and say that I'm done collecting the data, put the arm up.
So now we have our raw point cloud, right?
That's correct. This is my point cloud data, and you can see that it's really actually pretty good data. If I wanted to, what I could do now is I could edit the point cloud data. So I could select it, come up here to my cloud menu, and select the clean function, and just click and choose the data that I want to delete.
So you're just getting rid of any outliers or features that you don't want included in the finished scan?
That,
is that right?
That's correct. Okay. Or if my part was fixtured and I wanted to remove the fixture from the data, I could do that as well.
Okay.
So I'm just going to select that, say okay, and it gives me some nice clean data. I'm going to show you a reverse engineering process. So the first step of that was actually collecting the point cloud data. Next thing I'm going to do is to select that point cloud data and then create a mesh. And then after that, I'm going to use the mesh data to create surfaces that I can pull into a CAD package.
Okay.
The nice thing about this software, PC-DMIS Reshaper, is that it allows me to perform those steps quickly and easily. So I have the point cloud selected, and because I'm using the RS1 scanner, I can come up here to the RDS scanning function, and I can actually generate a mesh with one mouse click. The reason I can do that is because the software knows the properties of the scanner and also knows the properties of the point cloud data, and it can use those to automatically choose the correct parameters to create the optimum mesh. So I'm going to click that button and set my max triangle value here and go ahead and start to create the mesh. The system creates the mesh in a few different steps. It first creates a rough mesh and then it refines that and gives me the optimum mesh.
Now it created that mesh pretty quickly.
Very, very quickly. That's typically a process that is very time consuming. And in this case, it created that mesh very quickly. You can see here I have a mesh of the entire part. Now, even after I've created the mesh, there may be some small imperfections. And PC-DMIS Reshaper lets me correct those. So if I zoom in here on my part, you'll see in this area I have an imperfection. So I want to fix that before I create my surfaces, because my surfaces are only going to be as good as the mesh I created. So I'm going to come over here and select the mesh and come up to my mesh menu and choose the smoothing tool. And I could smooth the entire mesh, but I just want to work on this one small area. So I'm going to select that and then just select around the imperfection. And notice that I'm selecting some of the good data as well. What the system will do is it will go ahead and look at the edges or boundary of the area I selected and use that that data to continue that surface over the imperfection.
Okay, so it's assuming that the data surrounding the imperfection is the data that you want to basically copy, right?
That's correct, okay. Around the edges.
Okay.
So I have the mesh all cleaned up. My next step would be to place contour lines on the mesh. These lines would be projected directly onto the mesh. And the reason I want to do that is the contour lines are actually going to be the B-splines that I'm going to import into my CAD package. And where the B-splines intersect to form valid four-sided patches, that's where I'm going to get a surface that I can then pull into my CAD package.
Okay.
So there are many different tools that I can use for creating those curves. I can come over here to the contour tool and I can do cross sections. I can do a free-handed cross section. You can see it's just as easy as just drawing basically right on the mesh. I can also follow a contour of the curve or put contour lines tangent to a radius, which is a really nice feature that's used very often. Okay. So I go ahead and I complete the model, and I have all of my contour lines here that are placed on the model. And then after that's done, then I select all the contour lines and the mesh, and then from this I'm going to generate the B-splines and the patches. So I have that selected. Come up here to the CAD menu, and I'm going to choose patch from a set of lines. The system will go ahead and create the different patches and the B-splines, and now this is the data that I can pull into my CAD package.
And how would you get it into your CAD package?
What I would do is I would select the B-splines and then select the patches, and then I could just come over here to the menu, and I could go ahead and I could export those. And my export capabilities are either STEP or IGES.
Okay. So what we've seen is going from a point cloud to a mesh to patches ready to be exported into your CAD program.
That's correct. That's the process I would use for reverse engineering using the Romer 7-axis absolute arm with fully integrated laser scanner and PC-DMIS Reshaper.